Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another tutorial, and today we are gonna continue the Octane materials for beginners. So in the today's lesson, we're gonna see how to create this very nice anisotropic material, and you're gonna see that it's very easy to create that. Just a few clicks, you can have that. So let's get started and see how I made that. Okay, so let's begin. And the first thing I'm gonna do is delete this material and create another one. Let me re-render it again. Okay, so new material, you can name it properly. So let me see a name, Metal. Okay, that's a good name. So the next thing we're gonna do is transform this material to a metal material. So to do that, let's increase the metallic parameter over here to 1. So the next thing you're gonna do is change the BRDF mode here to the Beckman. So very shiny material right now, so let's work on that. So here I'm gonna use a noise procedural. So Shift A, S to search, and type noise. Noise texture. And you have to add two more procedurals as well. So let's add a full transform, Shift A, S to search, and type full transform, this one over here, plug it on the transform. So the next one will be a multiply texture. So Shift A, S to search, multiply texture. So this one I'm not gonna apply it right now. Let's plug the noise text on the BAMP node over here. Okay, so the next step is adjust the tile. So let's adjust, I think this is the y axis, so let's decrease it just to see if it's the right, yeah, it's the right axis. So let's use something like 0.02. I think it's a good number. As you can see, it's too strong. I have to reduce a little bit the power of this BAMP, but before doing that, I'm just adjust this noise texture here. So let's increase these octaves here just to, I don't know, maybe to something like 9. Actually, these octaves gives more waves, more lines to this noise texture. So as you can see here, if I increase it, it gives more line, so that's what we want for this. So let's put something like 10. Okay, the gamma, let's decrease it a bit, not a bit, actually a lot. Let's use maybe 0.01 negative. Okay, let's adjust the omega here. If you decrease it, actually it makes it bigger. And if you increase it, it gives you more detail. That's what we want. So something like that. And now to reduce a little bit more this BAMP power here, let's plug this multiply texture over here and decrease the texture too. So if you decrease, if you kill it, you're gonna see that we don't have like any BAMP effect on the material, so that of course is not what we want. So I'll increase it a little bit more to something like this, 0.2, and let's play around with this roughness as well. So let's increase roughness a little bit more, something like this. Let's adjust actually the anisotropy parameter over here. Okay, so set it to 1. Why I set it to 1? Because the direction needs to be horizontal. Okay, so here you can see if you increase, for example, the roughness a little bit more, you're gonna see that if I change anisotropy to -1, the directions of the reflection goes to the vertical shape. So that's why. So Let's set it to 1. So now it's on the right position. And let's decrease the roughness a little bit more. It was close to 1, I think. Something like this. Yeah. Maybe a little bit more. Not bad. Okay, so let's give more power to the bump. Maybe 0.4. Yeah, something like this. Still probably too shine, and I think I increase a little bit more roughness. So I have more this, I have a little bit more of this anisotropy effect. So yeah, actually it's pretty easy. As I said, that's it. I'm gonna show you another trick to improve this this shader as well, but this is, as I said, this is the basic. You can like create a very easy amateur like that, as you just saw. So it's important, like, create this kind of materials. Sometimes people, they just like put a metallic to 1 and that's it. I think this is the main cause of bad images. You have to work a little bit more on your materials, even if it's easy like that. Okay, sometimes, as I said, people like don't waste too much time on this, and it's not actually a waste of time. Definitely it worth it. You have to like put some more details on your shaders. So let's add some more details to this anisotropy material. So to do that, I'm gonna duplicate this material over here. Okay, so Shift D. Okay, and then I'm gonna add a mix texture. Yeah, it's mix material, this one here. Okay. And then I'm gonna apply, connect this to the surface, this material to the material 2, and this one to the material, to the material 1. And also I'm gonna add a noise material, noise texture, and I'm gonna plug it on the amount here. Okay, and now let's just adjust this material, the material number 1 here. So I'm gonna decrease a little bit the albedo, maybe give a little bit more of roughness. Okay, and here you can give more contrast to this noise texture here. So adding this noise texture will give to the material some stain, some color variation on this entire material. So let's see if you can have more variations. If you want to see it more clearly, if you can, you actually can change the albedo, like choose something more like a red, and then increase like the contrast. You're gonna see these stains over here. So maybe you can adjust here the octaves. See the omega. Yeah, it's not working very well. Also you can add modifier, not some modifier, actually a full transform here, and maybe decrease this guy here. So yeah, something like this. Okay, and now let me go back to the original color here. So let's kill the saturation, and yeah, here we go. Okay, perfect, looks really nice. And it's really realistic as well. Maybe it's too much, that is too much contrast. I don't like to exaggerate. Sometimes it's It's necessary, but I think this is too much. So here in the contrast, let me like decrease it a little bit. So yeah. So yeah, it's very nice. It's a very nice spot. Hope you have enjoyed it. And I'm not sure, like, for the next lesson, which material I'm gonna create, but stay tuned. And I'll be recording more videos to explain new materials. Okay, so thank you very much and see you in the next one.